Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Last week Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 152nd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Transporter 15.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Transporter 15.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1071, then landed successfully for the 30th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. Monday this week, SpaceX successfully launched their 153rd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 686.
One, engine full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1095, then landed successfully for the fourth time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 154th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1510.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1081, then landed successfully for the 20th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. Also on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 155th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 695.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1077, then landed successfully for the 25th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 156th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1125.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1097, then landed successfully for the fourth time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
H1 landing leg deploy.
Then, earlier today, SpaceX successfully launched their 157th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1115.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1088, then landed successfully for the 12th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Landing leg deploy.
Later today, possibly before this video goes live and into the week, we should see loads of Falcon missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 692 mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 7th at 9:40pm UTC or 4:40pm EDT. In a couple of days, on Tuesday, we should see a customer mission launch. The NROLL 77 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 9th at 7:16pm UTC or 2:16pm EDT. A day later and we should see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1511 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 10th at 8:54am UTC or 3:54am EDT. Another day later and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 690 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 11th at 6:59pm UTC or 1:59pm EDT. A couple of days after that and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1512 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 13th at 5:34am UTC or 12:34am EDT. Then, in a week, we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 699 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 14th at 1:37pm UTC or 8:37pm EDT. Heading to Boca Chica, the orbital pad 2 ship quick disconnect was seen being lifted to be attached to the tower. The ship quick disconnect was later seen lifted and attached to the tower. As they work on adapting Orbital Pad 1 for version 3 launches, the chopsticks have been shortened. Work has been continuing on the foundations for the air separation unit. Major work has been continuing on the new gigabase structure at Starbase. SpaceX posted some information about another Starship launch pad they received approval to build in Florida. They said, "We've received approval to develop Space Launch Complex 37 for Starship operations at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. Construction has started." SpaceX posted a cool video of them testing their Raptor 3 engine in McGregor, Texas. They said, "Validation testing on a Raptor 3 performing a Starship V3 ascent burn. Multiple versions of this test will cover the different conditions seen by Starship's three inner engines during its initial climb to space." The S39.1 test tank was seen rolling out to Massey's test site. This Booster 17 section was seen being moved to be scrapped. After the failure during testing, Booster 18 was cut in half for scrapping. The lower half was also cut in half for easier and safer transportation. This Booster 19 common dome section was seen being moved into Mega Bay 1. As they very rapidly build Booster 19, another section was seen moved into Mega Bay 1. And then yet another section was seen moving inside. As always, I have to say thanks to both Cesar Garcia and Colleen Liedtke for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.